Hello, I'm Dr. Ella Bonica. We'll talk about the influence of proper tongue posture on dental facial growth. The tongue constitutes an excellent example of the intimate and reciprocal interrelationship between structure and function. Tongue affects everything from the head to toe. The tongue and the breathing shapes the face. The shape of the dental arch is determined primarily by the tongue, but also by the cheek and lips, all of which have far more influence than the gene. The forces of the tongue play an important role in guiding teeth eruption and occlusion formation and maintaining dental arch shape and stability. The dentition is supposed to be in state of balance between forces from the outside, the lips and cheek, and forces from the inside, the tongue. The tongue acts as a support system for the palate and teeth, support system for the eyes, support system for the airway, and support system for cranial nerve function. The correct tongue posture can be influenced by tongue tie, lack or insufficient breastfeeding, mouth breathing, bottle feeding, spoon feeding, soft food, and reverse swallowing, low muscle tone, and pacifier. Of course, oral habits like tongue thrust or tongue sucking, and neuromuscular disease and genetic syndromes. During development, the size of the tongue in relation to the oral cavity is disproportionate, allowing the former to play a key role in shaping the palatine volute, with enlargement of the maxillary and mandibular alveolar process and in determining the curve of Spee and Wilson. The purpose of the tongue are, of course, very important in guiding nasal breathing, in swallowing, in broaden and develop the palate and jaws, neck and head posture, healthy digestion. Grow and development of maxillary facial morphology and oral posture and function are closely interrelated. The tongue position and posture influence the way the face grows and the alignment of the teeth. Malocclusion might be caused by abnormal functions such as mouth breathing, tongue thrust swallowing, and unilateral chewing, and by abnormal posture of oral circumferential muscle such as forward tongue thrust, tongue biting, and low tongue at rest. You can see this type of malocclusion that creates by a wrong or incorrect tongue posture. Because the tongue is so soft, many have largely ignored its influence, but in fact, the tongue is responsible for most malocclusion. However, if the tongue touches the teeth, the mechanism does not work, causing bruxism and TMD, and of course, jaw joint pain. The tongue has the ability to affect the position of teeth and other structure and the role in positioning the dental alveolar structure, although it is attached principally to the mandible and hyoid bone. The posture, the size, and the shape of the tongue are the main factor affecting the dental alveolar form. A short tongue length has been correlated with uprighting central incisor. A small overjet, a low ENB angle, impacted maxillary and mandibulary teeth and a step occlusal plate. Consistent with these studies, the result of the present study showed an increased tongue length that can flatter lower incisor group. Different tongue position and their malocclusion are very related with the size of the upper arch and the intermolar width. When the tongue is down and forward, due by the lack of the space in the mouth, the buccinator muscle continue to push and causing the upper arch to collapse. Children who mouth breathe have an undeveloped narrow maxilla with a height volute, and they can develop retrognathic mandible, and generally they have a very long face. Correct oral posture during growth with the tongue on the palate, with the lips sealed and the teeth in light contact for about minimum 6 hours a day, will ensure room for 30 to straight teeth and a nice looking face. So tongue posture affects the shape of the face. A good posture can result in a very nice profile, a nice looking face. When a child jaw is too short and the palate too narrow, tongue cannot rest against the root of the mouth and instead rests against of the lower teeth. This causes them to routinely breathe through the mouth and a healthy habit. Then as they lie flat to sleep, the tongue may fall back to block the throat and causing apnea. This can worsen into a vicious circle through overuse of bottle pacifier or sippy cup and misshaping the teeth and the mouth. The skeletal orthodontic problem usually are the most challenging class 2 and class 3. I will show you an example with a mandibular retractatism, with a long face, an incorrect posture, mouth posture, open mouth posture, incorrect tongue posture, and mouth breathing, and problem breathing. And we guide the facial growth so the tongue can have more space in the mouth, and you can see the changing in the profile, increasing the upper airway, also enhance the all appearance, facial appearance. Then maxillary retractatism with open mouth posture, breathing problem, postural problem. We can correct them, of course, by guiding the facial growth and especially the upper maxilla forward. Of course, the kids is still in treatment. It's not a finished treatment yet because class 3, they are most challenging cases. The tongue volume, beside posture and function, it's crucial importance. It's a very important in etiology of malocclusion and dental facial deformities. Macroglossia and its consequence are well new in the Beckwin-Wiedermann syndrome and acromegaly. It was suggested as a possible cause of open bite and a mandibulary prognathus. And I will show you a teen female patient. These are initially pictures made by another clinic, by another orthodontist in 2013. She started treatment at the time, but she got a wrong treatment plan, she got a wrong diagnostic, and she could have been saved by surgery, but she gets a wrong treatment, unfortunately. She had a long tongue posture, a big tongue. And in 2015, she came like this in my office. So she spent a year in treatment getting no results. In fact, she was worsening. So we debonding and we made a new treatment plan for her. And because she had so many periodontal problems, she started to have root reabsorption and very bad hygiene and gummy inflammation. We decide to accelerate the treatment and we decide to combine orthodontic treatment with orthognathic surgery. So in 2018, we can see a picture just before and immediately after surgery. A year later, when we finished the treatment and she came back to our office, you can notice the difference. Of course, we don't like to send patients to surgery. That's why early treatment, it's very, very important. Tongue posture is significantly lower in class 3 subject as compared with class 1 subject, and the difference is mainly present in the posterior region. In all subjects, tongue posture is associated with the ratio of the dental and alveolar characteristic of the maxillary and mandible. Therefore, as a clinical implication, the monitoring of tongue posture and movements, particularly in class 3 patients, would be recommended, and a comprehensive treatment for class 3 skeletal malocclusion should include the correction of improper tongue posture in order to enhance treatment efficiency. According to Dr. McNew, the back of the tongue is controlled by our subconscious and those connected to your body postural system. The front of the tongue represents our conscious mind aspect, and therefore we can control it easily, but with consistent effort. So when we became unconscious in sleep, the front of the tongue doesn't really know where it's supposed to stay. Generally, the anterior part of the tongue is considered important for non-respiratory activity, while the posterior part is important for respiration. It should be emphasized that all the tongue muscle, extrinsic and intrinsic muscle group, always work synergically and not separately. The tonus of this muscle must be well balanced, otherwise dysfunction can occur, resulting in alteration in the position of the hyoid bone and the functionality of the tongue. The behavior of habitually posturing with the tongue on the palate has a number of important benefits to the postural system also. First, provided one has enough nasopharyngeal space, it facilitates nasal versus mouth breathing. On the other hand, posturing with the mouth open lowers and reduces the tongue, mandible, and hyoid bone. This can occlude the oropharyngeal airway space, resulting in compensatory posterior cranial rotation to further open the airway. As a result of this reposturing, in order to level the ocular plan due to the upper cervical and cranial expansion, the neck assumes a more forward and reduced cervical lordotic posture. If the tongue is positioned against the palate, the parasympathetic system will reduce its systemic activity, but if it's positioned against the soft palate, the sympathetic system will reduce its activity. The tongue position and its voluntary or non-voluntary strength might vary with the tongue volume. So the tongue position influences the whole body. Tongue thrusting, it's the reason for misaligning and bite problem for nearly half of orthodontic patients. Anterior tongue thrusting can also lead to anterior open bite due to the repetitive forces against the front teeth coupled with the tongue habitually resting against the incisor, which typically accompany this motor pattern. In the case of swallowing disorder, the tip of the tongue pushes against the upper and lower teeth, or the interocclusal space, the middle portion, is lowered or extended unilateral, and the posterior third of the tongue rises against the back of the hard palate. After every swallow, the teeth should become back into occlusion. It is also common for the tongue to be resting on the mandibular teeth and in between the arches with a severe swallow behavior impacting proper eruption and occlusal relationship of the tongue. So you can see in the image the different tongue posture affecting and creating different kind of malocclusion. An habitual tongue and palate interference help direct growth and development of the craniofacial system. The tongue in opposition to the palate provide a mechanical stimulus that is interpreted at the cellular level to promote osseous growth. John Mew advocated the tongue is meant to rest in full contact against the entire palate, which include the heart and posterior soft palate. This clinician supports this position and find that the best posture outcome are associated with the ability to achieve this tongue and palate relationship. In agreement with Dr. Mew, the tongue exerts its most beneficial physiological function when resting against the entire palate, which can be divided into thirds. A restricted tongue, therefore, can have the following effects on skeletal growth and development, as well as airway development. It cannot rise to the palate and cannot put pressure on the upper airway. This can lead to narrow upper jaw and upper jaw that do not grow far enough. Insufficient development of both maxillary and mandible lead to crowding. When left untreated, sometimes this patient turns into adults who have TMJ problem issue, SDB, OSA, forward head posture, neck, back problems. Ankyloglossia has been correlated with reduced intercanine and intermolar width. OAB, overjet, and size of spacing. Ankyloglossia also is leading to maxillary hypoplasia and mandibular retrusion. Forward head posture and tongue tie. Many of tongue tie, for example, posterior tongue tie can cause other muscle groups to start compensating for the tongue's inability to move and rest properly. This can cause pain and tension, which can turn and exacerbate forward head posture. So the position of the tongue is crucial. The reason behind this lack of the tongue palate contact in many cases is due to a lack of flexibility of the tongue to adequately contact the entire palate. If one is still not able to achieve a proper tongue-palate relationship after diligent stretching, then consideration of getting cutting the tongue tie to free the tongue might be appropriate. The tongue needs to rest on the top of the mouth, feeling the palate from front to back. When it doesn't, it can impact the position of the head on the neck and the neck on the body. And of course, a low resting tongue can lead to other symptoms and condition. I see my practice every day from sleep apnea and other type of sleep disorder breathing to jaw pain and tension and digestive problem and many other. A problem with the tongue posture can create or enhance pediatric sleep disorder. Once this tissue, tonsil, and adenoids become inflamed, the child is often forced to bring the tongue forward or to breathe with the mouth posture, open mouth posture, further exacerbating the inflamed tonsil and adenoids. An anterior tongue posture can lead to fluttering of the front teeth and dental open bite. The tongue is directly linked with oropharynx. The back of the tongue makes up the front wall of the oropharynx. As the tongue moves forward and fills the oral cavity, it is moved out of the back of the throat, opening up the airway. In less than 1 year, in this girl case, we almost double the airway size, so the tongue can move forward, and you can notice the correction of the hyoid bone, the decrease in tonsil and adenoid sides, and changing in the direction of the growing phase to an anterior and forward growing phase, not vertical. The resting posture and functional pattern of the mouth, face, head, neck may disrupt normal dental and skeletal development, which may also influence full body posture. A good resting posture of the complex is believed to be front two-thirds of the tongue elevated into the upper arch, not touching the front teeth, lips together, and teeth slightly apart or in light contact. Tooth movement is understood to occur with light continuous forces of a minimum of 6 to 8 hours a day. An adverse resting posture and functional patterns of the lips and tongue may include mouth open, lips open, resting posture. Forward resting position of the tongue either between or against the front teeth. Posterior tongue posture against or between the back teeth. Inappropriate tongue thrusting of the tongue in speech or in swallow. The vertical lift to the third and posterior heart palate and not horizontal extension past the incisor, it is the most accurate measurement of normal lingual function. Tongue tie may restrict correct tongue posture, but first we need to consider why they exist. There is good evidence to suggest that they are there because the tongue is not in the palate, and if the tie is cut, it will reform if the tongue is not used properly. Too many clinicians correct the symptom when they should address the cause. It is easy to tell a child to close their mouth, but very difficult to create a natural closed mouth posture. These are from Professor John Mew. And they are very, very choose in all this sentence. Impact of oral resting posture, muscular pressure on facial bone, or the lack the position of the tongue in the root of the mouth can influence directional growth over time. Low lingual resting posture was correlated with both class 2 or class 3 malocclusion. The statistic lingual posture addressed slowly changes the face and the swallowing pattern and occlusion, of course. Atypical swallowing develops as a compensatory movement pattern when normal movement is inhibited in some way. A tongue thrust swallow involves excessive perioral effort and the tongue exerts forward or in lateral pressure into the cheeks rather than vertical pressure into the hard palate with a front to back motion. This swallowing pattern reinforces a low resting posture contributed to high narrow palate, posterior crossbite, and further malocclusion. So, how can we get a proper tongue posture? We can suggest to the patient to place the tip of the tongue in the palate just behind of the frontal teeth. The remaining borders of the tongue should be in contact with all the surface of the upper and the back teeth and gum. This tongue position should allow to create a seat between the root of the mouth and the tongue, such that could create a clicking sound if you open your mouth quickly. This proper tongue posture can greatly affect the muscle harmony of the jaw and neck and should be protected all the time in order to develop it into an unconscious habit. Of course, we all know about the traffic premise, so the tongue should rest against the palate, lips sealed, and teeth in near contact. We now say the teeth should be in eye contact for minimum 4 or 6 hours, ideally 8 hours per day. This will result in a perfect occlusion with a good looking face. So, also this correct tongue posture and keeping the traffic premise will ensure that the patient will grow up with good looking faces and that can save them from complicated treatment later and even surgery. Even the old fashioned rule can create good looking faces. Grandmother's advice was often right. So, unfortunately, in this time, these are not very well kept. The face is very sensitive to oral habits when child is young, and simple things like leaving the mouth open can make a very big difference. The training of oral posture of function, encouraging tongue to palate contact at rest during swallowing and speech, and train the lips to be in contact at rest and during speech is very important. Teaching the child to keep their teeth in eye contact also, and this, of course, can be achieved either by exercises or eye appliance. It is new that keeping the tongue in the wrong place while the mouth is at rest for many hours each day is more responsible for damaging than the tongue thrust swallow. An anterior open bite due to abnormal swallowing pattern can force the tongue to direct forward and create an open bite. The severity of anterior bite is greatly influenced by the presence of a thumb, finger or lip sucking, mouth breathing habits, and poor labial musculature. Another type of tongue thrust is lateral thrust. Lateral open bite become evident when the tongue is retracting from between the teeth. This is one of the most difficult habits to correct and detect because the patient is not aware of it. A lateral tongue thrust might interfere with the eruption of premolar and depress the teeth. And class 3, the tongue is placed low and the mandible, which is held forwards. Being further from the palate, this leads to a collapse of the maxillary arch and the whole maxilla in severe cases. Certain responses are seen at a group level and may follow genetic predisposition, of course, but consistently sealed lips reduce the downswing aligned anterior teeth and establish a class 1 incisor pattern. The tongue posture with correct tongue in the palate forces, the majority of the forces are upright. And with the power function, the majority of forces are distal because of the buccinatory ring. Also, when a wrong swallowing pattern and a low tongue posture, we can get this endognathia and the all teeth are lingual inclinated. Establish a proper rest posture and retraining the tongue thrust swallowing patterns to healthy swallow can help to guide the teeth in a more desirable relationship during the growth and development. It can assist orthodontist in aligning the teeth and jaw properly, assist stabilization of the teeth during and after orthodontic treatment, and especially in surgical cases, and enhance overall appearance and allow clear pronunciation of speech and sound. But often the speech is improved after oral myofunctional therapy also. With this removable appliance, kids learn subconsciously over time to keep their mouth closed. This became the new habit and proper posture pattern is established. And with closed mouth, the tongue was very good chances of a natural raising up and resting on the top palate. By retraining the closed mouth and tongue on upper palate posture with proper swallowing pattern, over time, the maxilla come forward and you get the drastic positive changes like in a general cases. Thank you for your attention.